Hi everyone, I'm Ellie from Code of the Future, and today we're going to be doing another mini project, and this time it's going to be creating your own random password generator. So as always, I'm going to move you onto the screen and we're going to get started. Okay, so we are in PyCharm as usual, and I have created a Python file called random password generator that's ready for us to start doing our coding. The first thing I'm going to say is this is incorporating a load of different things that we've done over the last few tutorials. It's a project that's quite specific to strings, but again, it incorporates absolutely everything that we've done. So I hope you enjoy this video and we're going to get started straight away. So the first thing that we're going to do, and this is the most important thing, because we are doing a random password generator, we need to import the random module. So we're going to say importing the relevant modules, and we're going to say import random. Okay, perfect. That's the modules out of the way. That's that done. So now we can get stuck into the actual coding. So first we're going to start by doing an all uppercase password. Now the first thing we're going to start by saying is our password is going to start by being an empty string. Okay, and that's because we start with an empty string and then we're going to add random letters from Python onto this password. So to start with, we need it to be an empty string. You could, if you really wanted to, start with the password as hello, but that's quite an obvious guess for anyone that wants to guess your password. But just for the ease of this video, we're going to start with an empty string. Okay, so we've assigned password as nothing so far, as a string, but there's no letters or anything in this string. The next thing we're going to say is for I in range. Now this is where we need to figure out how long we want our password to be. So let's say we want it 10 characters. That's quite a long password. And obviously if they're all going to be random letters, then that's quite a strong password as well. Again, we need the colon, and as we enter, it will indent because this is a for loop. And now we're going to say I is going to equal a character from random.randint between 65 and 90. Okay, and something that I've just noticed, and we're going to just move this around, we're going to move the importing relevant modules just to make this code a little bit nicer. Instead of import random, we're going to say from random import rand int. And then here we're just going to get rid of random, and we're just simply going to have rand int, and here we're going to get rid of random at the top. Okay, so what this is doing is instead of importing random straight away and then saying random.randint, we can simply import randint, which is, if you remember from one of my previous videos, it's a random integer, and then we can do this straight away. So what this is doing is it's going to let I equal a character of a random integer between 65 and 90. Now in Python, if you remember from my strings video, letters have numbers and numbers have letters. So in Python, characters within 65 and 90 are all A, B, C, all the way to the end of the alphabet, but in uppercase. Okay, so what this is doing is it's going to let I equal a random integer from 65 and 90, and then produce the corresponding character, which subsequently is a letter from the alphabet, but in uppercase. Now we're going to say let password equal string of the password plus I. So what this is now saying is our password is going to equal the string of password plus I. Okay, so we're going to talk through what this is doing. So the first thing it's going to do is let I equal a random character between 65 and 90, which corresponds to a letter in the alphabet uppercase. Okay, so that's going to be a random letter in the alphabet, and then it's going to say take the original password, which is nothing to start with, make it equal to a string, and then add this random letter on. And it's going to repeat 10 times, so it's going to add a random letter each time. So we're going to say print password, and hopefully this is going to produce an all uppercase password of random letters, and it's going to be 10 letters long. Perfect, look at that, we have a very, very random password, perfect. We can extend this and make it lowercase if we want, so we can put here lower at the end of here, and if we run, it will make it all lower. Perfect. For the ease of the video, we're just going to keep it as upper because we've said here it's going to be an uppercase password. But now what I'm going to show you is how you can create a random password generator that each time you go along, it's capital letter, then lowercase, then uppercase, then lowercase. So we're going to say upper and lowercase password. We're going to follow exactly what we did before, but just change a few things here and there. So we're going to let password equal to an empty string again. We're going to say for I in range, we're going to say I in range 5 this time, and you'll see why in a minute. Okay, in range 5. We're going to let I equal, again, character of rand int between 65 and 90. And then within this for loop, we're going to add another for loop, and we're going to say for j in range 5, let j equal the character of rand int between 65 and 90, and that's going to be lowercase. Okay, now don't worry, this might seem like a lot of information to begin with, but I'm going to explain exactly what's happening. Now we press enter, and we're going to move back so that we're in this for loop again, and we're going to say password will equal string password plus I plus j, and then we're going to say print password. So we're going to print this, and then I'm going to explain exactly what's happening. So we're going to click run, and look at that, perfect. We have a password that's 10 letters long. Every time you go along a letter, it goes uppercase, lowercase, uppercase, lowercase, and it's random letters, perfect. So what this is doing, and we're going to explain what this is doing. So as before, we have password set to an empty string so we can add some random letters onto it. We let I in the range 5. Now this section here is accounting for the uppercase characters. So we let I equal a random uppercase character. And then within this loop, we're going to let j equal a lowercase letter, which is what you can see here. So we have I is an uppercase letter, j is a lowercase letter, and then we're going to let the password equal the string of password plus the lowercase plus the uppercase. And that's why we have it in range 5, because each time this loop runs, it's going to add a lowercase and an uppercase, which is 2 letters, and then we repeat that 5 times and we get a password that is 10 characters long. So similarly, we could put in here 10 and we could click run, and there we go, it does it 20 letters long. Okay, but we want, you know, 20 letters is quite a long password, so we're going to keep it with 5 for the time being. So that's it, that's how it works. Just this little bit here is saying the password is going to equal the string of the password plus the lowercase plus the uppercase. And what's worth noting is every time you go around a loop, this password in here will be something new. So to start with, it'll be empty, and then we'll add a lowercase and an uppercase. Then we'll go around again, and it will be the lowercase and uppercase from before. And then it will add a new lowercase and uppercase. And then it will repeat, repeat, and repeat. And that's why we see it has uppercase, then lowercase, you know, uppercase, lowercase, throughout the whole password. So that's how you can do a very, very simple random password generator. I think it's quite a cool topic. It's a nice way of incorporating how strings work, characters, and again, loops. You'll notice that throughout your whole coding journey, loops and if statements and stuff like that are the forefront of your coding journey. So hopefully you'll have picked it up by now. But don't forget, if you do have any problems, just give me a message. On our social media. Instagram is probably the best one to reach us. The link will be in the description box, or just comment on this video if you do have any queries, and I'll do my best to help. But that is the video today. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, then please like, subscribe, and comment, and I will see you all in the next video.